Recently, someone asked me, how long is a marathon? 42.195 kilometers, I told him.
After finishing the Los Angeles Marathon, we decided that we would do something different. There is an exclusive club of marathon runners called the Seven Continents Club. We wanted to be part of it, but with a difference. We chose the seven marathons that were more exotic, exciting, and challenging. Definitely not the average city marathons, but the marathons less run, the path less trodden.
We would like to share with you some of our experiences and memories of our exciting and challenging journeys across the world.
People go to Africa to see the wildlife and to see the animals run. But we went there to run with the animals. We ran a marathon in Africa. While it was very nice and pretty to be running with the animals, it was also unbearably hot as we were close to the equator. And the run was a tough one at high altitude on very rough terrain. From Africa, we shifted to the Australian outback, to a gorgeous place called Uluru, near Alice Springs.
Our next run was in Mongolia, Gobi Desert Marathon. Under the hot sun, all alone in the desert, listening only to the blowing wind, the Gobi Desert run was a great experience.
The next place we ran was Buenos Aires. Our next port of call was Porto. Porto in Portugal, the birthplace of port wine. The final leg of this journey was Antarctica. Antarctica is a frozen desert, very cold, where even bacteria doesn't survive. Getting to Antarctica is as difficult as running in Antarctica. We were supposed to hop off into Antarctica, a four-hour flight from a place called Punta Arenas at the southernmost tip of Chile. We had to have a weather window, clear window of about 8 hours for our flight to land in Antarctica and come back to Punta Arenas. We packed our bags and we were waiting for the window, which never came. We waited for 4 days, waiting for our 2 hourly bulletins to see if the weather has cleared. And since it was 24 hours daylight in Antarctica, the weather bulletins continued throughout the 24 hours day and night. After a very, very patient wait, we finally reached Antarctica. The winds in Antarctica were like a hurricane, but we put our best foot forward and moved on.
The run was at minus 20 degrees centigrade. Carrying about 4 layers of clothes, we have to run at a steady pace all through. If we slow down too much, the body temperature may fall, leading to the sweat turning into icicles. Even though the temperature is very low, the sun was very harsh, and we should wear glasses to protect our eyes from UV radiation. One of our co-runner temporarily blinded because he removed his glasses while running. It was a great moment to cross the finish line with the national flag in our hands, and the flag was looking beautiful with the backdrop of the white glacier.
As we finished the Antarctica Marathon run, we asked ourselves, what now? Now that we are members of the Seven Continent Club, what next? Uma said, why not we do the Grand Slam? A Grand Slam is a run on seven continents plus the North Pole. The North Pole is different from all other runs. Unlike all the continents, the North Pole is on the Arctic Ocean. It's nothing but frozen seawater. Getting to the North Pole is one of the toughest travels we ever had. We started off at a place called Svalbard, and we took off from Svalbard on the 6th of April. We were supposed to run on the 7th and return back on the 8th. As we approached the runway for landing at the North Pole, the ice on the runway cracked and cold water from the Arctic Sea started gushing up. We had to abort landing, turn back, and then started the agonizing wait. We waited for 2 days with a lot of uncertainty. not knowing when the runway will be repaired, whether it will be repaired or not. And finally, the engineers at the camp managed to build a new runway. And after 2.5 days, they finally took off.
What's your game plan? What's your strategy? Do you have a strategy?
Keep going. Take it easy. No stress. Not too fast. Aim for 8 hours. And happy if I do it in a little less than that.
So you could be finishing at 6 in the morning?
Yes, prepared for that.
All night?
All night. We're going to run all night. That's another exciting thought.
Looking forward to it. Are you looking forward to it, or are you just anxious?
Looking forward, at the same time a little bit tensed, excited. It's a mixed feeling.
We have landed at the North Pole from plus 34 degrees centigrade to minus 34 degrees centigrade.
We ran throughout the night in very rough terrain over mounds of ice, soft snow with our feet sinking, sometimes ankle deep. Very rarely even to a knee deep, and in some places we could see cracks in the ice, and we started wondering if this is a crack which would be similar to the crack on the runway. And finally, after a agonizing 9 hours of torture, we crossed the finish line together, holding our flag high, and this was a great moment in our life.
Proud not only for ourselves, proud for the country too. Today, Uma and I have become the first Indians to have run a marathon on the North, completed a marathon on the North Pole. In addition, we are also the first couple to have completed the Grand Slam. Mighty proud.